It's basically for building small spacecraft that could be used to test out various technologies or science experiments or things of that nature. When it's all put together, it's about 18 inches across, about a foot tall, and it's no more massive than a single person can pick up by themselves. What these satellites are really good for is taking a process that you're still learning how to do, like make a certain kind of measurement, and iterate on how do you make that measurement, make it better, and design your instrument better, because the cost of going to space with a full-up spacecraft is so high, you've got to do it perfectly the first time. Well, if you could back off on that a little bit and do it in an iterative fashion, and do it so you build a little, fly a little, build a little, fly a little, and make it so that you learn as you go and improve as you go. Hopefully, 10 years down the road, you've had several missions and you've learned a lot, and now you're making the real measurements you want to make with high reliability. What we're doing right now is we're getting all the pieces to talk to each other and getting them up and running. Like most good engineers, we're fighting with getting Windows installed on the flight computer and making it work right. People think we're nuts for putting Windows on, but the reason we're doing that is right now we're testing out some different concepts, and it's a lot easier to do that in a Windows environment where we can use things like LabVIEW and some other utilities and test out how it's going to work. We're using a very small computer. It's what's called a PC-104. It's a very capable little computer, and it makes it easy for us to write programs on and test things out. So this is really a test environment. I also have some interface standards that I want to try out that haven't been tried out in the small environment that make it easy to do plug-and-play components. So like in your regular computer where you just plug something in the USB port, one of the things I'm really interested in is, can we apply that philosophy in the satellite and just take an instrument, plug it in, and have it reconfigure and come up and running right away. I've been talking with a number of different researchers on site to try to figure out what might be some candidate science instruments that we could try out in this environment. So we're trying to test out some basic sensors and see how they work, and invite other people to bring in sensors they may have and see what it would take to actually fly it in this configuration. Where I hope NASA is interested in all of this is for testing out new technologies and new science detection methods, things of that nature, that you just don't know how they're going to work. And you don't want to build a whole multi-million dollar, hundreds of millions of dollar spacecraft if you've never tried out the measurement first.